हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल ऑल अबाउट सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय प्रवीण माने। टुडे हियर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग हाउ टू डिजाइन अ स्टेयरकेस। टुडे आई हैव टेकन वन न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन द हाउ टू डिजाइन द स्टेयरकेस व्हिच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर सिविल इंजीनियर फॉर अ डिजाइनर टू कैलकुलेट द क्वांटिटी और ऑल्सो इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स स्टडिंग इन सेकेंड ईयर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। So the problem is, question is, plan a dogleg staircase for a building in which the vertical distance between the floors is 3.6 meter. The stair hall measures 2.5 meter by 5 meter. So here we are preparing the staircase hall. This is called a staircase hall whose length is 5 meter and breadth is 2.5 meter. So here this 2.5 meter and 5 meter does not include the thickness of wall. So this is the landing, this is the passage, and this is the steps. So flight 1 and flight 2. As you know, dog-legged staircase is having two flights. So now start with the steps. Step 1, assume the length and height of tread and rise. Let riser be 150 mm and tread be 250 mm. These are some we can say this may be a standard for residential building or commercial building. It may riser may change from 150 to 175 mm and tread may change from 250 to 300 mm. Tread is based on our foot length. So you try and check foot length, and the riser is 150 mm, that is the height, so that no one can everybody can easily rise their leg up and get on the next step. So now second step is, width of stair is approximately 2.5 by 2, is equal to 1.25 meter. As there are two flights, so width of one flight is 1.25 meter. So choose 1250 mm. Then step 3, calculate height of each flight. Height of each flight is calculated by dividing. As there are two flights, we are dividing the height of the building vertical distance between the floor. Vertical distance between the floor to the by 2 is 1.8 meter. That is 1800 mm. Number of risers required in each flight is equal to 1800 divided by 150 is equal to 12. So number of tread required in each flight is equal to 12 minus 1. As you know the relation, riser is equal to tread plus 1, or tread is equal to riser minus 1. Now step 4, as staircase is a vertical transportation, it is a means of vertical transportation in the building from floor to floor. That's why we are calculating height in this way. Then step 4, calculate space occupied by total tread. Total tread space occupied by is equal to 11 into 250 is equal to 2750 mm is equal to 2.75 meter. Then step 5, calculate remaining space is equal to 5 minus 2.75 is equal to 2.25 meter. So step 6, assume landing length, or we can say width, landing length or width, you can say 1.5 meter. This landing width, we can assume the after one flight, you need landing to rest for some time, so that to avoid the tiredness during the vertical transportation for the people, those who are not easily get all the steps to be all the steps to and reach the next floor. Then assume landing length is equal to 1.5 meter. Then space remained again is equal to 2.25 minus 1.5 is equal to 0.75. now if then what you do, you can, this landing width, sometimes we may take 1 meter. or we may take 1.5 based on the conditions. Or then, if not, the remaining space 0.75 meter, that is 750 mm. So to use this, you can increase the tread dimension. You increase tread dimension 300 mm. So and then calculate the number of, then calculate the this and take the landing width approximately. If not, then remaining space can be used for the passage. The remaining space can be used for the passage in the floor at floor level, or you can increase the width of your or length of your you can increase the length of this width or length. You can say this is length, this is width. This width you can increase. Then, or you can increase the number of steps also sometimes. So that in that case, you need to minimize the riser height. So if you minimize riser height, then there will be the in more number of treads. If more number of treads, then your distance easily matches. Otherwise, you use this for the space. A staircase requires four columns. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four columns required by staircase. Then, as this staircase is dog-legged, so there will be no any distance between the two flight. So this is negligible distance provided between two flights. So this is flight 1, flight 2 and the landing. So this is the, this way you can design the staircase, and this way you can design the staircase so that and learned how to design the staircase. So this will be useful for you to design a staircase. Now take next problem, that is a plan a dog-legged staircase for a building in which the vertical distance between the floors is 3 meter, or you can take 3.2 meter, and the stair hall measures 2.5 meter by 4.5 meter, 2.5 meter by 4.5 meter, or you can take 2.5 meter by 5 meter, and you solve this problem and comment in the video. So if you are like the video, please do share it and subscribe the channel for more such fruitful videos. So thank you again.